There has been a recent concern about cancer risk after knee or hip replacement. And the reason is that cobalt metal, which is present in many knee and hip replacements, was recently upclassified by the international authorities to potentially carcinogenic and mutagenic. The European Commission upscaled cobalt metal to category 1B, which means that it is presumed to cause cancer in humans. And the World Health Organization, in 2022, based upon the advice of a working group of 31 scientists from 13 countries, even upclassified cobalt metal to class 2A, which means probably carcinogenic to humans. Both decisions came as a surprise, because since the routine use of hip and knee prosthesis in medicine, the cancer risk in patients that had undergone knee or hip replacement has been relatively well studied, and the conclusion of most analyses so far has been that the risk for cancer is not increased after knee or hip replacement. So, then why did the European Commission and the World Health Organization decide to upclassify the cancer risk for cobalt? Well, this was not based upon data retrieved from patients, but based upon two studies performed in rodents, where the effect of metallic cobalt powder inhalation was studied in rats and mice. In these experimental studies, there was no doubt that increasing concentrations of cobalt inhalation led to increased cancer development in the respiratory tract, but also elsewhere in the other organs. Based upon this research, and as a reaction by the orthopedic implant industry, an extensive analysis was conducted and co-authored by researchers from the major implant manufacturers, including Stryker, Johnson & Johnson, Zimmer, and Smith & Nephew. Amongst other analyses, they also performed a systematic review and meta-analysis, including 30 studies on a total number of 653,000 patients at an average follow-up of 14.5 years. In this very extensive analysis, they showed that overall the association of cancer with joint replacement was zero for 22 of the 27 studied cancers. Negative, so less, for 3 of the 27 studied cancers: stomach, intestine, and some respiratory tract cancers. And positive for 2 of the 27 studied cancers: prostate cancer and multiple myeloma, which is a bone marrow cancer. For both cancers, there was, however, no significant increase with higher exposure levels or longer follow-up duration, which one would expect if there would be a causal relationship, because then the number of cancers would increase if the exposure becomes more intense or longer in duration. Based upon all of this, the authors state that the current evidence is insufficient to conclude that there exists an increased risk for site-specific cancer development after knee or hip replacement. With this, it is important to note that all authors, except one, work for medical device companies that manufacture and sell cobalt-containing metal implants, which may be considered as a potentially competing interest. Now, what is my personal interpretation of all this? Well, first, it is good that governmental bodies inform and regulate about potentially hazardous substances. It is also good that industry and researchers confront this with on-field observations. There exists a theoretical risk with cobalt metal based on animal data. In human joint replacement, with cobalt-containing metal implants, this does not seem to have been a problem over the past 30 years. Nevertheless, cobalt-free alternatives, such as for example oxidized zirconium or titanium niobium nitride implants, which already exist quite for a long time, may need to be increasingly considered. Thank you for watching.